SPXL is 3 times of SP500 index. SSO is 2 times of the index. As these funds were created in 2008 and 2006, I did a simulation back to 2000. This is a simulation of SPY, SSO, and SPXL. Assume the initial values were 10,000 at the dot-com bubble in 2000. The lowest point was in 2002. SPY would have been 5,200. SSO 2,200. SPXL 870. SPY dropped 47%. SSO -77%. SPXL -91%. How about the lowest point in 2009? SPY 5,100. SSO 1,300. SPXL 270. From 2002 to 2009, SPY dropped 2%. SSO -39%. SPXL -68%. So SPXL would have dropped 97% from the highest point in 2000. What would the values be in August 2021? SPY 42,000. SSO 47,000. SPXL 33,000. The y-axis is the log scale. If we check the linear scale, it is clear that all of these three funds would have been higher than the highest point in 2000. Let's go back to the log scale. This simulation factors in the dividend, management fee, and the tracking error. SPY has dividend, SSO and SPXL has about 1% of management fee each year, and the leveraged ETFs also have tracking errors. SSO has -2.5% annual decay due to the tracking error and the management fee. SPXL has -3% each year. If you like this video, you are welcome to hit the like button and subscribe.